Hey guys, it's Nico, back with another video, this time from the game that just dropped yesterday, Gran Turismo Sport. Now this gameplay is from the beta from the week prior. I unfortunately don't have the game as of yet. I'm hoping to get it within the next couple of days. But this gameplay, I just want to talk about my thoughts on the beta from last week and my thoughts on the game release from earlier this, from just yesterday. So this gameplay, I'm on pole. I'm the first car right there in the Nissan GTR, and you see the Bugatti there in second. This is one of the daily races. So immediately, first thing off, I love how they added the brake bias, the ability to change your brake bias, your traction control, and your fuel map. You also get a course map and all that good stuff. I really do like that feature that they added. I don't think it was in GT6, but you know, I didn't really play GT6 that much. So you see the Bugatti completely threw it down my inside and completely missed the corner. Then I missed turn two, and then the two cars get back by me. So immediately, the first thing I noticed about this game when I first started playing it is how good this game looks. This is the first game that GT released on the PS4. GT6 was only on PS3 and obviously GT5, which I played extensively. But this game, just this track looks incredible. This game in general, look at the mountains in front of you there, the sun glare off the car, it looks really, really good. The track looks good. You see the rubber already put down for, like, get some qualifying. This game looks really, really good. It's like it's on par with Forza 7 on the Xbox over there. But this game just looks incredible, and I'm pretty sure it looks even better on the PlayStation 4 Pro, which I don't have that, obviously, but this game just looks really, really great. Second thing, I love how the cars sound. The cars sound good for the most part. How the cars feel, even though they still have that little issue where you can launch the car in front of you when you hit them in the rear. The game, the cars feel so good. Like when they go through the corner, you can feel like the weight kind of shift over. Like you can feel the car roll over. You feel the bumps on the tires. You feel the track, really. And a GT tried to give you that simulation feel. It's the simulator. So this game, once again, does an incredible job at giving the gamer, the driver, the best kind of feel. And again, there's also project cars out there on the market. There's, you know, Forza and, you know, a set of Corsa. There's so many other racing games right now, but I think GT personally does probably one of the best jobs at giving the driver the best kind of feel. So I'm going to back to the gameplay here. We come to lap two, and you see the car in fifth place gets smashed off, and he absolutely overcorrects. And that's the other thing I want to talk about in this game. I play on a controller right now. I do have a wheel. I have a Logitech G29, but on the controller, it's really easy to snap the car back and completely wreck yourself out of the race. And as you saw there with that car who was in fifth place, I guess he's on a controller because he had no chance of saving that car. And I don't know, I'm pretty sure it probably feels even better on a wheel, but unfortunately for the beta, I didn't feel like breaking out the wheel for a couple hours and then having to put it back up. I have a racing stand on it now, so I didn't feel the need to bring it out and set it up and then hook it up to the PS4. So I just decided to use this time to see how the game feels on a controller. And honestly, to me, it didn't feel that badly. It didn't feel like I couldn't do it. Like I'm pretty sure on Project Cars, it's harder, even harder to use a controller for Project Cars too. But this game, I feel like it's adaptable. You can make adjustments to it and actually run this game on a controller. Now, the next thing which I want to mention about this gameplay is right there, you're going to see me kind of overshoot the corner to get a penalty. Now, this year, I don't recall last year's iterations having a penalty system like this. This is kind of it's similar to iRacing, where you have to yield time if you end up cutting a corner or you end up like making contact or something like that. You have to yield time back by letting off throttle. In previous iteration, they would just take control of your car, whether it's a 5-second penalty, a 10-second penalty, and it was completely ghost your car, and you couldn't do anything. It was just like you have to take the penalty. This one, you have the option to completely ignore it. You can ignore the penalty, obviously, and take it at the end of the race, or you can let off the throttle and take it on the track during the race. So, as you see him right now, I'm still in fourth place, and I'm going to try to get around this car here in third. I kind of cut the corner there a smidge, and then I cut around this outside, and I get another penalty, I guess, for cutting the corner from before, and I immediately set the penalty there, which, again, I absolutely love. I think it's a great feature that they add in this year's game. Now, if you notice some cars that come to pit road, I had the thing on lean the entire time. This race started you off on number one, which used max fuel. I changed that because I didn't realize the first race, this is the second race I did. The first race I did, I didn't realize about the fuel map. I completely forgot. But the second race I did, I totally remembered, changed the fuel mode to lean, the least amount of fuel to be used. And you saw right there, the guy in second place, or guy in first place, he ran out of gas, missed pit road, so now he had to labor back all the way back around with limited, or to no fuel, basically, out of gas, basically. And that's not how I wanted to do this race. So I put the thing in lean and was able to take the lead here, as you can see. I think second place ran out of gas. Obviously, third place ran out of gas. And that was basically the race for the most part for me. I was just enjoying the scenery, enjoying the trees, enjoying how good this game feels and looks. Again, let me know in the comments below how you guys, you know, what you guys think of the game, if you guys are enjoying it, if you guys have any issues with it. I'm pretty sure they're going to patch any issues they have, if they haven't already, you know, because, you know, GT likes putting out those massive patches, like 4 or 5 gigs, that will take up more space in your PS4 if you don't have it. Extra space. So yeah, just overall, I'm really enjoying this. I really enjoyed the beta. Again, I haven't bought the full edition yet, but I really did enjoy the beta. Again, the cars look great. The track, this track, which I've never raced on before, looks pretty damn good. Like, it feels and looks, it looks and feels like a real, like, real life track. Like you will see like Formula One on. I believe it's not even a real track, but it looks great. The corners flow really nicely together. It's just overall just a really, really good race to me. A really good racetrack, I feel. And I'm hoping to get it, you know, and maybe in a couple weeks, maybe by Black Friday. Black Friday's in about a month and a week away. Maybe for Thanksgiving I'll get it. Maybe be discounted, but and I know that they're gonna come up with DLC, so maybe you need more tracks, maybe more good tracks that look just as good, even better than this. And you know, maybe some more cars. I'm hoping they add some NASCARs. That would be like the ideal thing for me if they add some NASCARs to this game. So NASCAR race cars like they had in GT5 and GT6. But that's it for this race. I will end up coming across the line in the lead, and I go on to win this race. Technically, I guess it doesn't count because it's a beta and it happened before launch, but I'll take it. Any win I can get, I'll take, because I'm not the one to win all that often, you know. So I'm very happy with that win, and I thought I would showcase just a little bit of the game and talk about my thoughts, my opinions on the game and how the game's looked and felt to me. Doing the missions were a cool feature. They've always had missions, but just I feel like they added more to, like, so you can learn the track now. Like breaking points, they added that ability, even the ability to have your hazards on, which if you use the center console left and right, you can actually toggle on and off the indicators. But that's it for this video, guys. If you guys did enjoy my commentary and did enjoy the video and my race win, hit the like button, please subscribe and share this video with your friends, and I'm Nico, and I will catch you guys later. Peace out, Cub Scouts.